On this episode of Ask Dan, I'm wearing a Windows Ugly Sweater. Thank you, Windows Insider team, as well as for this scarf. But I also take your questions. So this week, we'll be talking about Windows Core OS. Can you expect it on a phone? When should you expect Windows 10 updates to stop coming to your older hardware and Surface headphones? Are they actually good for work? All that and more. Stay tuned. My whole family has Haswell-generation i5 or i7 PCs. Will we stop receiving spring and fall feature updates when the hardware is no longer compatible? All right, so this is a really good question. It's regarding Windows 10 as a service. So this idea that Windows 10 is never finished. And for some people, that sounds really bad. Like, when are they ever going to finish it? But that's just the way it is now. And no, there's no finish point here. Windows 10 is always improving. We're on 19H1 now for the spring, if you're on the Insider Fast Ring. And the question is, when does this stop for people who have older PCs? And it's a really good question because we don't really know. At some point, Microsoft will announce that it doesn't support older processors, but right now they're going back quite a few years for older hardware. So yeah, you can have a PC from 5, even 10 years ago maybe, and still be putting on Windows 10 Fast Ring builds on there, or regular Windows 10 releases, and still be getting updates. And that's sort of the challenge that Microsoft has versus, say, Apple, who doesn't have as many laptops. Microsoft has to contend with and test all these different devices along with Windows 10. And you can make a strong argument here that as Windows 10 has progressed, well, the hardware requirements have never actually increased. This is a very vastly different experience from, say, Windows Vista, where you needed some really good hardware to get that full Aero experience. You don't need that with Windows 10. So to answer your question, there's really no end date here for Windows 10 and when you'll stop getting updates. It's going to go on for a long time. And that's really good news because Microsoft is forcing no one to buy a new computer. But what they are doing is introducing new experiences for people with certain new hardware. So for instance, Windows Hello or Windows Inking, if your PC doesn't have that, well, you can't get it. If that's something you like, well, you will need to buy new hardware, but you'll never be required to do so. I know Microsoft has no plans to release a smartphone again, but what are the chances that a partner such as Wiley Fox, Nokia, or Dell producing one based on Windows Core OS, since not all of us need a large foldable device? We haven't seen a lot on Windows Core OS, at least publicly yet, but sources tell us, and according to Zach Bowden, our senior writer at Windows Central, that 2019 may be the year we actually get to see Windows Core OS in action, specifically Windows Lite, what's it being called now, for desktop and laptop devices. So we may get a first glimpse on that. If you don't know what Windows Core OS is, we've done some other videos on it. It's basically the next iteration of Windows with some Win32 components stripped out. Think of it as a combo between Windows and Chrome OS. So could a manufacturer take that, say, put it into a phone, since they will have telephony support, at least for something like Andromeda? It's a really good question. I'm not really sure that manufacturers could do that or actually would do that. There's a lot of investment to making a phone, even if there's no market for it, for Microsoft and its partners. And I think while technically it's feasible, I just don't see that as happening. I think Microsoft's really going to drive this idea of a foldable device that you can either carry with you all the time. And I think their OEM partners will follow suit. I really see a lot of companies moving beyond the traditional smartphone, what we've seen. We've already started to see this now with Android. There's rumors too with Apple working on devices like this. So it seems like the whole industry is moving towards dual screen devices. And it's going to start to seem weird to come out with an old screen device, but yeah, you never know. We may see some Kickstarter stuff. I really do like this sort of new economy where smaller companies can produce new and limited niche hardware for users who want it. There may be that possibility. I just wouldn't bet on it. For the Surface headphones, when they're connected to the PC and phone at the same time, are there any problems? Is it easy to connect them with the PC and mobile? And would you recommend them for work? All right, if you haven't already seen it, go check out my Surface headphone review. I don't like to pat myself on the back, but I thought it was a pretty good review. And I answer actually a lot of these questions in there. And to get more specific, one of the main selling points of the Surface headphones is this idea that it works with multiple devices at the same time. So yeah, you can have it paired to your PC and your phone at the same time. If a phone call comes in, well, it'll go through the headphones. Meanwhile, if you're listening to music on the PC, it dynamically switches between them. Besides my experience, a lot of others have been reporting online that this works very well for them. They haven't had any issues. In fact, like I said, it's sort of the main selling point. So regarding a question for work, yeah, I think these are really ideal for you. This is sort of how Microsoft is positioning them, that you're sitting behind a PC all day wearing headphones and you're going to be switching between your devices. And this is the problem I have with the Sony headphones, which are otherwise basically perfect. I really do like those Sony headphones, but they had the limitation of being able to only actively pair with a single device at a time, which is really annoying because then you have to choose between your PC and your phone. If you're using your PC and a phone call comes in, well, you got to take your headphones off and answer the phone. That's just a no-go for a lot of people who are looking for a multi-user, multi-device system. So yeah, Surface headphones, they've been working out very well so far. I still think Sony still excels overall in audio and noise cancellation, but in terms of just ease of use and functionality, Surface headphones have done a really good job and they'll be perfect for you. With the recent news of Microsoft Edge shifting to the Chromium engine, how will this affect Windows sets in the future? All right, just for the record, I'm saying Windows sets, S-E-T-S. I know people hear other things. So this was a feature that was previewed last year, or early 2018, I should say, going to 2019. But it was this idea of tabbed windows all throughout Windows. It's a really cool idea, but the execution of it was flawed, and it didn't really look that great either. Microsoft took it offline. They're going back to their drawing board. And part of the reason we're not seeing it is because, yes, they are shifting to Chromium. We have a full article on this if you want to know about it, including an FAQ answering a lot of these questions. So regarding sets, we did ask Microsoft specifically about that. And sets is not canceled. It is basically on hold while they do shift to this new engine because, yeah, they can't do both at the same time. The Chromium shift with Edge is going to be an ongoing project. We'll start to see a preview release for it in early 2019 for developers who want to download. It'll be pretty rough, but it'll work. I don't expect a consumer-facing version of this to probably late 2019. And probably around that point, we'll start to hear a little bit more about sets, which I also expect to have a more refined UI, some more improvements going on, and it'll work better with Chromium. There's a lot of questions here regarding Chromium and how deep it's going to go into the OS. Right now, it's only affecting the Edge engine specifically, which does affect sets, but it doesn't go down into the OS level for affecting for WebView and apps itself, at least not yet long term. Microsoft probably will do that, but right now, it's just going to affect the browser. For regular users, they're not going to notice anything. Of course, you're just going to launch Edge, it'll just suddenly work better, but all you will know why that is. But sets is still on the table. I think it's still a really good idea, and I'm glad Microsoft is sort of taking their time here to make sure they get it right, listen to user feedback, and well, with Chromium powering things, it should be a pretty interesting thing, but don't expect it till sometime in mid to late 2019. All right, that does it for the final episode of Ask Dan Windows for 2018. Don't worry, we'll be back next year as always. In fact, you can use hashtag Ask Dan Windows on Twitter or shoot me an email at askdan@windowscentral.com. You can also leave me a comment below. If you like this video, give us a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching. Take care, everyone.